Dear Chair and listeners, I have first to acknowledge that I am neither a Sami nor a native Finnish citizen. Thus, my presentation is one of an outsider. A closer analysis of books and book collections give us a more accurate view of book history, especially in the case of marginalized groups such as the Samis of Finland. I will first sketch the historical context of the 19th and the beginning of the 20th centuries, after which I shall present the recent emergence of book history research in Finland and the situation of Sami book history in its context. I will also present some Finnish book collections and the Sami speaker voices within that history. Samis live in a large region in northern Fennoscandia, stretching out from the eastern Kola Peninsula to northern Finland to northern Sweden until Norway, in a territory which has been divided by countries during centuries. Nowadays, we have three Sami groups in Finland, the North, the Inari, and the Scots Samis. Today, I shall speak only about the Davi or North, and honor or Inari Sami book history because the first Sami court books were published much later. Finland has been overruled by other empires, first by Sweden and then by Russia from 1809, while the young Grand Duchy gained an autonomous status, the outcome of which had even more significant consequences for the Samis. To uphold this new status, politicians and scholars collected around ideologies which led to the formation of the Fennoman movement. During that time, they developed and standardized the Finnish written language. This enabled the majority population's literature to grow considerably. A result of the print capitalism described by Benedict Anderson, to which Sami book history benefited only to a very small extent. In Finland, mainstream population labeled Samis as a minority. As Linda Smith explains, even at the minimal level of representation, indigenous communities are often thrown in with all other minorities as one voice amongst many. I would add that it is a manner to build up hierarchy, an outcome of which is that priority is given to the mainstream population in political decisions. In the semi-historical context, the outcomes were that only few measures were implemented to ensure Sami language use, which can be observed in the Sami book history. Many Finnish historians have considered that Finland has been in a minority position ruled by other empires, and thus they have been unwilling to see that it might also have taken part to any colonization policy, considering it to be only the issue of the effort of the biggest countries to maintain their power in overseas territories. Those historians are familiar with an ideal of Finland as a homogeneous country, neglecting its diverse cultural aspects. We could even argue that Finland could be seen as an emerging community at that time. Discussions concerning Finnish colonialism in its northern region, the Finnish Sapmi, is slowly emerging in academic spheres due to the works of Sami scholars, such as Veli-Pekka Lehtola and Rauna Kuokkanen. Debates evolve around what is referred to as an internal colonialism. The Finnish book history research has unfolded from the 1990s by studies focusing on the early Finnish translations for the mainstream population. Only few mentions are made about Sami books, and mainly in the framework of church history. too many historians maintain that the Sami did not want to read Sami translations by affirming that they do not consider the fact that Finnish clergymen gave to Sami books translated in Upmeya Sami Kiela or Umea Suomi, which Samis living in the Finnish Sapmi did not understand. A request had been addressed to the Swedish king by bishops at the end of the 17th century to translate books in different Sami languages, but it was not taken into account at that time. And here you can see the first World Bible translation, which was made in Umea Sami. The Sami book history has to be decolonized by changing the mainstream academic perspective to add more attention to the diverse written culture to be analyzed. In that respect, we have to pay more attention to the voices of the Sami speakers themselves, although it represents challenges because we can find only few testimonies in journal articles or in archives. This book history reveals the mission history of Nordic countries. The first translations were published to support activities of missionaries to Christianize the population and thus to reinforce the presence of the state in the north. The first translations were published in Sweden in 1619, but in Finland the first one were published only in 1825. The Sami book collections kept nowadays in Finland are mainly located in university libraries or in institutions. The most significant collection is the family Fellman family Lampolika Fonds, which Pastor Jakob Fellman and his son, the president of the Court of Justice of Vasa, Isaac Fellman, collected for their works. Jakob Fellman was the first Finnish pastor who succeeded in publishing Sami translations, but they were subject of harsh critics. The reason why he did not publish all translations and manuscripts he had written. He asked that his son to complete his work, which Isaac Fellman did by drafting a large research on the Sami history of Finland, for which purpose he collected an impressive number of publications alongside almost all first Sami translations. The fund's history is enlightened by an intensive correspondence carried out by Isaac Fellman with different scholars and other individuals. The collection of letters is kept in the National Archive. Another interesting collection is the Finno-Ugrist's Henrik Yrjö Toivonen's one, which his widow dedicated to the Jyväskylä University Library in 1956. And here you can see one book of the donation to which an ex libris was added at that time. Several pastors and other clergymen's books are held in the Oulu University, where the Sami Language and Cultural Institute of Finland, the Kielaha Instituutta, is located. A course analysis of those collections books marks with archive material gives a better view of the book Sami book history. Those collections reveal a specific development in Finland. The Sami research unfolded late in comparison with other scientific fields. Finno-Ugrists having long focused their interest on Finno-Ugrian groups living in Russia, the trends changed slowly after the Russian Revolution. However, we can see tremendous development due to the works of the Sami research in the academy. The maintenance of catechism with too few Sami translations, often with the help of translators, by neglecting the teaching of other subjects, can be seen as a mark of the Finnish colonialism. The first two remarks made by Sami speakers on that issue can be read in several manuscripts and articles. The first Sami of Finland admitted to the gymnasium of Kuopio to become a catechist was Aslak Laiti. During his training, Laiti wrote Finnish articles. In 1860, he tried to explain the danger of the schooling situation of the parish of Otsejoka or Utsjoki, emphasizing the problem due to the implemented catechism, which led the Samis to try to get a better education with Finnish books they did not understand. He tried to ask the authorities for more sustainable translation work, which was not done until several decades later. Laiti's position must have been awkward if we look at the tremendous surprise of the Finnish journalists to see a Laplander, as they designated him, being able to graduate as a catechist in 1861, which was sadly not surprising at that time. Laiti explained how beneficial it would be to see a young Sami admitted to the Finnish teacher's seminar founded in Jyväskylä in 1863. His wish was fulfilled in 1911 when Pieter Helander, later known as Peda Hirvi, was admitted there. Soon after his arrival to the seminar, Peda was chosen as the editor of the student newspaper. He wrote an article about schooling situation on the Samis, explaining how it should be better organized. The journal is kept in the Jyväskylä section of the National Archive, and here you can see a picture of it. During his stay in Jyväskylä, Peda was often asked to present his homeland, which led him to write Finnish articles published in the regional newspaper and in another review. He presented the oral tradition, the Jok, in the following way. It reflects the spiritual life of Lapps, their suffering and hopes. Although they might seem strange, they are the precious national characteristic of the Sami people, and thousands of them can be found beyond the mountains of Tairi. Let them teach the Sami people to look at their most ancient history and consider in them their own ancient spiritual capacities. At the same time, let them show the way to the growing generation with better creations. In that extract, we can observe a shift from the term Lap used by the mainstream population to Sami used by the Samis themselves. It could be argued to be a reflection of a certain kind of political positioning. I consider it to be more an attempt to encourage the Samis to be proud of their own language, culture and history, which had so often been seen as meaningless. Until that time, very few Samis had the possibility to present their people and their culture themselves. Jalvi had planned to translate books for pupils to come, an idea which he was not able to fulfill because of his untimely death at the age of 28. However, he succeeded in writing the novel published in Jyväskylä, which was the first Sami literature work ever published in Finland. And to conclude, the very few translations and writing of from Sami speakers reveal the problems occurring due to the shortage of Sami books and the challenge they had to face when they tried to inform officials on the importance to implement better schooling programs. Here I show you shortly the first Aarne Sami translation published in Finland. The Sami book collections contain significant testimonies of Sami reading history. Some books have been proved to be overused by covers very much harmed with fires of the huts, and also because they were used as long as possible by wool families. Some books were handover from person to person, as you can see with that book's annotations. The Sami book history cannot be approached as it is usually done in Finland, using estate inventories, auctions, and bookstore lists. Because of the lack of bookstores in the north, books had to be brought by clergymen to those parishes. And here is one of those, the list written by the church clergyman for the book to be sold. Finnish books historians have neglected church inventories, which clergymen had to write to indicate the ownership of churches. Those inventories contain sometimes mentions of the state of the books, of person who donated them, and or the price. They contain also mentions of Finnish literature which have not been taken into account in studies carried out on the division of those books in the entire Finland. In the case of the parish of Huodekiri or Sodankylä, we do not find any mention of Sami books, which is a clear mark of the Finnish colonial policy. The archive of the Fellman family contains a letter of Pastor Pekka Herald Heikel, in which he explained that the catechism was provided in Finnish while the family spoke Sami with each other, which he considered to be wrong. The Finnish authorities were not so keen to sustain too many translations, as I tried to explain. And here you can see some numbers of the current translation and other publications. Sami written culture unfolded more consequently only from the 1940s, after the foundation of the Sami Joukkosjärvi, the Society of the Promotion of Sami Culture, in 1932, with which first publication were facsimiles and translations published at the time of the Grand Duchy. Some historians seek to underline the benefits of encounters of the Samis with clergymen. By doing so, they neglect the fact that requests made by Sami catechists were not considered while a larger schooling program was implemented elsewhere in Finland. Furthermore, the policy had had long-term outcomes which led many Samis to ask their children to be taught in Finnish in the hope they would have more chances to cope within the Finnish society as future adults. This can be put into perspective by the fact that Sami teachers still have difficulties to find material in the mother tongue of their pupils for some teaching subjects. Olu kiitos, and I thank you for your attention.